What's up guys, and welcome back to another episode of the PS5 Career Mode. This is episode number 39. And we start today's episode off with the Community Shield. Yes, the FA Cup winners against the Premier League winners at Wembley for what is, as I always call it, a glorified friendly. Yes, heading into the game, wasn't really too fussed what would happen in this. Of course, our first Community Shield of the save. It's always nice to start a campaign off with a win and a little Mickey Mouse trophy as well. But I wasn't overly fussed what would happen in this game, whether we would win or we would lose. So heading into the game, I did decide to pick a mixture of starters and reserves for the game because, of course, this season, playing in the Europa League, having so many games coming, as we know, we like to go on those cup runs as well season after season. So naturally, we're going to have to rotate our side around a lot. And I want to see this season if any of our fringe players can like nail down a starting spot on a more regular basis. So there were chances in this game to show me what they could do and why they should get more minutes either playing in Europe or in the Premier League or the Cups as well. And taking on the Reds, as you can see, we lost the game by 2-0. Never really got going. We did have some shots, but they weren't really too noteworthy. The Reds were the far superior team. Scored the opening goal through Diego Jota. And Firmino wrapped it up towards the end of the game in a 2-0 win for the Reds. Again, the stats a bit deceptive, really. It seems like it was quite balanced. It really wasn't. It was very one-sided indeed. If it wasn't for Foster in our goal, we probably would have lost the game by 3 or 4 goals, really. And speaking of Ben Foster as well, I still can't believe he's 40 years old. His deal's not coming at the end of the year, but he's like, no, Gaffer, I'm not ready to become a full-time YouTuber just yet. I want to keep on playing for you, and I might give him another one-year extension if he agrees to sign it, because I love Ben Foster, man, I really do. Are you guys watching his YouTube channel? I shouted out before, the Cycling GK. I'll leave a link in the description down below. It's my binge-worthy channel at the moment. I absolutely love it. It's really, really awesome. Still, as you could see, following that, we had our fixtures coming for the first month in the Premier League of August. We're starting off opening night, Friday night, with a rematch of the FA Cup final. Don't tell me the Premier League didn't do that on purpose. Really looking forward to that Leicester at home. We've got two big games in London derbies as well, with obviously Spurs and Chelsea to start the campaign off as well. And then recently promoted Bournemouth at home as well is the final game of the calendar month to start the campaign off. And a brief look at our academy as well. Of course, in the last episode, the board said what they want from us this season is another player coming out of the academy and being a regular in our starting 11. Well, as you can see, there are some names to choose between. Young, the South Korean winger, Mark Bassey, the Nigerian defender as well. I must say, quite a few players to choose between from that academy that could possibly make their mark this season as a regular starter in our first 11. So, as you can see, right before the first game of the season against Leicester, I thought I'd run you through the squad just real briefly before the opening day, or opening night, I should say, really, and show you what we're working with this season. You know, again, I really do like this team, and as we know, it is now a 4.5-star team. The growth has been absolutely fantastic since the very first season. Real briefly as well, I want to show you this too. Cameron Wilkinson this year is going to take a first-team squad number. He made a statement last year by picking number 51, but this year I'm giving him number 4. It is vacant, so I'm going to give him a first team squad number. He definitely deserves it. Exciting prospect, and his development plan, by the way, only has a few weeks left on it, so very soon he'll be getting a position change officially to holding midfield, whereas we know that's where he plays the vast majority of his games now. But yeah, I do really like the team. You know, again, it is still quite young. There are some veterans here. You know, again, you've got Ben Foster, you've got Adel Tarat, David Silva, who, as we know, is retiring come the end of the season as well. But again, it's a really nice blend of youngsters and teenagers, players in their early 20s, players in their prime of their careers, and again, those veterans, those dressing room leaders in the 30s as well, which I really, really like. I'm not sure who exactly right now is going to be our star of the season. Last year, you'd say it was Nketiah with Ball following closely behind, but again, I've got big plans for Charlie Kelman, because as you would have seen, there was a round past him really quickly. He's back here from his loan spell in France, and the American last year won the Ligue 1 Golden Boot, as we know, guided Lille to second place in the table, and he's up to 79 overall. Ridiculous, massive upgrade given to him from EA, and again, I'm excited. He's got the exciting prospect tag now. He's got a potential upgrade as well. I know it's most likely a bug from EA, but listen, we're profiting off it big time. I'm excited for him, and if Nketiah does go into that mid-season struggle like he did last year, I've got faith in the young American to come in and show us exactly what he made of himself whilst playing out in France as well. So, very excited for the season. Hopefully, again, we can can finish in fifth place, I'll be honest here. That's unlikely. I mean, seriously, you know, the board have given us incredibly strong objectives this year. They want us to win another piece of silverware. For me, I'm not targeting fifth. I think that's a bit unrealistic. I definitely think there's a chance. We've got a good enough team. It's 4.5-star team now. But really, break up the top six? No one's done that yet. I don't think we've got the quality to do that personally myself. It is doable, but it is incredibly unlikely. I'm targeting 7th or possibly 8th. Last year finished 9th. To me, 6th would be incredible. I don't think we're going to break out the top 6 though. So 7th or 8th is where I'm targeting this season. So opening night was a disaster. I'm just going to be totally honest. It was really, really terrible. Very little went on. Freddie Woodman made one good save towards the end, but that was it. Really, really poor game. 0-0 to start the campaign off. Not exciting at all. And following out a bid for Chris Willick, which you rejected, and also Newcastle, funnily enough. I thought it was really interesting. Woodman last year was sublime in his first season for us. He's in the top 5 for clean sheets. Started a campaign off with a clean sheet on the opening night as well. And the Magpies said, can we have him back, please? Can we have Freddie back at the club? And I was like, Steve, no, you've got Johan off us. You're not taking Freddie as well. He's staying with us. We absolutely love him because he is such a smart goalkeeper. I really do like him in this year's FIFA. So for the second game of today's episode, start the campaign off. Now taking on Spurs here at the Conference Foundation Stadium on the back of the poor 0-0 draw on the opening night. Early on into the game, worrying signs, as you could see. Woodman making a great save, but then Charles Bull going down and staying down. He did get back up to his feet and play for the majority of the game, but eventually did come off. And again, in another kind of tepid, relatively tedious game, and a very tough one at that, another goalless draw. So to start the campaign off, as you know, people know, as thankfully Bull's injury was just a bruised shoulder, it's just a 5-day injury. As people know, we're a defence-minded team. We play really strong defence, but back-to-back goalless draws to start the campaign off. I don't know what it is, man, but I really, really struggle to score goals in this year's FIFA. And perhaps a tactical change is needed this year for us to bang in more goals on a regular basis. Who knows? Thankfully, though, as you could see, Cameron's development plan has now officially completed. He has now become an official defence midfielder, and because of that, I can now give him appropriate growth development plans. And as you can see, the role I'm going to play him in this team for development is the ball-winning midfielder role. He's got the stats to do that. He's quick. He's got great energy. All he's missing really is a high defensive work rate and a little bit better defensive stats as well. So that's what I'm going to try and train him in, that ball midfielder role, because to me that's where he'd be best at. And delighted at Wilkins' development. Took a while to get there, but frankly it's now finished, and he is an official ball winning midfielder in this team in the defence midfield position. Still following the bid, following development plan, you can see there was a bid here for Jamal Lewis. What was really interesting, Hoffenheim wanted to take him to Germany. Now they signed Omar off us at the start of last season, and I said, I'll tell you what, you can have Jamal if you give us back Omar. They said no. Get lost. Alvi the same. Yeah, not going to come off, was it? 87 rated. Omar Richards is now at 24 years old. Oh my word, these stats are absolutely unbelievable. And I've talked about it a few times this year. As you can see, Brighter say Samuel's now up to 84 overall as well. I've talked about it a few times this year. Players do grow really, really quickly in this year's FIFA career mode. So I guess it was to be expected. But still, I was stunned when I saw it. 87 overall, just 24 years old. What I will do for Omar back in our starting 11, man. I loved Omar, man. I'll be honest here. It was probably my favourite player in the series before we sold him to Germany. But yeah, he's staying there at Hoffenheim. We just don't have the money to bring him back yet, at the very, very least. We'll keep Jamal though. He's done well since coming in. Scored in the FA Cup final last year as well. So yeah, Jamal will be staying and Omar stays in Hoffenheim for now. Still, for the third game of today's episode, I was thinking, come on, we've got to get some goals in this one, surely. And we did indeed, but unfortunately not for us. Yes, away at Stamford Bridge for the West London derby here against Chelsea. Kai Havertz scored the first goal of the game, where Charlie Kelman got his first Premier League start for us since coming back from his loan spell, and almost scored a cracker of a goal as well there, hitting that shot off the crossbar as he tried to bend one in from the far corner. And unfortunately, this was one of those games where things just didn't really go our way at all. Just didn't really get the luck in this game. You know, you get a sort of games every now and then, you don't really get to rub the green. Kai Havertz scored their second goal and his second goal of the game, but really probably should have gone down as an own goal, really. A massive deflection and ricochet as the ball trickled past Freddie and into the back of the net. And we did play some good football in the game as well. Got some good chances. Kelman had a couple of really good ones as well, including that one there, heading that cross wide and behind for a goal kick. But sadly, it remains a very tough start for Queen's Park Rangers. Yes, 2-0 was the final score. Havertz bagging a brace. Again, played really well, to be fair. She didn't get a rubber degree in this one, but it is how things go sometimes. And again, another game where we failed to score. To start the campaign off, 3 Premier League games, 2 draws, 1 defeat, no wins, and no goals scored either. Concerning start for Queen's Park Rangers. And as we know this season, playing in the Europa League, we will, of course, be taking it seriously. You know all about those European hangovers. I'll tell you what, this could be a very tough season indeed. And following the game as well, a big bid for Ilias as well, Diego Simeone, wanted to take him to Atletico Madrid. And I was thinking, do you know what? We rejected a bid for Nketiah. We rejected a bid for Willock as well. We had quite a few bids coming in for our players this season, Metham as well. But with Ilias, I think Atletico Madrid, one of the strongest sides in Spain and in Europe as well, I think realistically, I'm probably going to have to cash in, again, mainly for the realism. I love Ilias, one of the season one OGs. He's grown so, so well. But again, I think, for realism's sake, I probably would have to cash in and sell him. Regardless, for the fourth and final games of this episode, it was indeed Birmingham in the EFL Cup second round. Of course, we would pick a totally weakened lineup for the game, as we won't care about this competition at all. We've got far bigger fish to fry, man. Europa League, Premier League, our FA Cup when it comes around as well. Too many games to squeeze into the calendar to worry about this competition as well. So I feel the totally rotated lineup. Kelman bagged a brace, which was really nice. Season's return from France, whilst we would lose a clean sheet. Ben Foster made an extraordinary save in the first half. Life in those old bones yet, but despite losing a clean sheet, we still held on to the win and we are through to the next round of the EFL Cup. Not doing too fussed about it though, of course. It's mainly a competition for the kids and the fringe players to prove they deserve a little bit more game time. But the Premier League though, can't paper over the cracks much, can we? Not a single win in our first 3 games or goals either. Listen, long way to go. We just began the campaign, but it's still a very disappointing start. But that was this episode of the PS5 Crew. Guys, a big thank you for watching. We hope you have enjoyed it. If you have, then please do drop a like. Much love to you all. Have a fantastic day, and I'll see you for the next episode featuring Transfer Deadline Day, which you will not want to miss. Absolutely crazy transfer drama, and I'll see you for it very soon. Do not miss it.